Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you very much for all that you've been doing, and I think the next 30 to 40 minutes are all yours, sir.
Wow. What a stage. If I did not know that ARC is a real estate company, I would have thought it's a showbiz company. Doing so whoever has done this incredible job, I love the dances, I love the you know laser show, and of course the chairman's speeches and everything. So let's make our own show, because now you guys are into show business. So can you do one thing? So your motto is above and beyond, right? So we will dim the lights, dim these lights, everybody, and everybody open their mobile phone and open the torch. Torch, you know torch? I'll show you the torch. Yes. This one? Yes. Everybody. It only works if everybody does it. Because I'm going to make this my Instagram story. Okay. Like this. And I'm going to make it. Okay, guys. I'll do 1, 2, 3. And you have to do above and beyond. Okay? Clear? We'll do dress rehearsal. Okay? I'm not doing right now. Okay? Okay, guys. I'm in Hyderabad right now with the ARC group. Let's do it. 1, 2, 3.
From left to right. What's this? Left.
All right then, someone else did it for me. Thank you guys, thank you so much. Now we can come back to my talk actually. But you can turn the torch off, you can have some more lights on the audience. Audience lights. Yes. How are you doing? Good? Okay, 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 okay. Yeah. Telugu? Tamil? Tamil Teriya? Okay, no, that doesn't work for me also. It's okay, I'm just checking. Thank you once again for having me. 30 years, I just saw the passion. I like it when I come to something which is very entrepreneurial, you know. It's, can you all hear me at the back? You can hear? Good. So, when I come to something like this, it's very inspiring to me, because I've also considered myself as an entrepreneur. I know writers are not seen as entrepreneurs, you know. People want writers to be poor. Yeah, certain professions have the image. Like real estate developer has to be rich. Otherwise, what are you? But writer has to be poor. But I try not to be very poor. That's because I look at my job as an entrepreneur, you know. And I think you can show a spirit of entrepreneurship in any job you do. It's not just for the CEO to be entrepreneurial. If you're in the finance department or you're in the HR department, wherever you are, you can try to be entrepreneurial. And I'm going to talk to you about that. How many of you in your 30s here? 20s? 40s? Come on, guys. I'm 45. 60s, so it's okay, same 40 only. 60 is the new 40. So you're all in this age where you are figuring out. How many 30s? People in the 30s again? 30 to 40, your age. Yes. This little boy, how can you be 30 to 40? Look at him. I know. That's not possible. Okay, so you know, I will talk to you about how to keep that spirit. Because ARC is 30 today, many of you in your 30s, some in your 40s, I'm going to talk to you about that. I'm going to talk to you about how to stay motivated in this middle years. You know, this is interval of your life. Half is done, half is left. So I'm going to talk to you about that a little bit. How many of you read a lot of books here? Okay. So if you ask the experts, you know, literature experts, they will tell you that Chetan is not the best writer. Sir is saying yes also. Thank you. Feeling very welcome. You know, they will say that I'm not the best writer. And you know what? They are right. They are right because I am not supposed to be even writer. I am a mechanical engineer who became a writer. I am an MBA. I used to work in a bank who became a writer. You know, so therefore the literature people are right. You know the literature people, right? Those people who return their awards and all that. Award wapsi wale log hai na sir. So they don't like, but you have called me to be your keynote speaker. Aisa kaise ho gaya? How in life someone who is not the best gets known the most? How is it that you can win when you may not be the best? You may think there are other companies which are 10 times bigger in real estate. How will we compete with them? But I am telling you, I am living example. I myself admit, I am not the best writer, but I have become the most popular writer in the country. So I want to talk to you about that. That's something you have to learn in life, that you don't always have to be the best to win. I am not the best. I am best selling. Now you are in business. All in business. So best selling is good. Right? I'm okay to be best selling. Who decides what is best? Award wapsi people are deciding who's best. I don't know. But how did this happen? Why does this happen all the time? This is something they don't teach in school. And I'm going to tell you about this today. So you can learn and apply this in your business, right? I told you I'm not the best because this is my experience. I was in Goldman Sachs, then I'm in Deutsche Bank, then I'm a house husband right now. Anybody? House husband, housewife here? Any house husbands or housewives here? Sir is there, chilling. It's the best job. Sir, I'm telling you, you may be CEO and all good, but house husband is best. They never give this job option to boys. When they are growing up, they never tell boys, you can be this also. Why they don't say? Equality hai toh phir hona chahiye na sir. So I like it. It's good. You know. I want to tell you why I write and what do I do. Because some of the things I do, people find very strange for a writer. So it's important to understand my goal first. My goal is to bring about change. My goal is to bring about change in our country. You can see the news every day. All sides of chaos is happening. You know, we are always fighting, we are always trying to do something. So I want to make India better and try to bring about a change through my writing. Many ways to bring about change. You can become politician, but it's very difficult. Politician is like a tough job, man. Because it's very hard to lie 24 hours. But it's a job. And if you want to do well, you have to do all that. So it's not easy. You can become an activist. Activist, you know. But I'm Punjabi. Any Punjabi people here? One I see. Any Punjabi? No, sir, have you ever seen a Punjabi person go on hunger strike? We can't go. It is not in our DNA. When we are angry with the government, we eat more. We are not going to like say, oh, government is not doing job, I am not eating food. I can't do all that. So I use a two-step strategy. My business model is this. First, you entertain people. You make people, feel good. You just make them enjoy. And then you give them some knowledge. My business model is same as that of a madari who shows you the monkey dance. What is the business model of monkey dance? First, he shows you the monkey dance. There is no ticket for monkey dance in India. There is no ticket. Everybody watches free, right? Then, after the dance is over, he comes and sells you some churan, something for your stomach, for masculinity, something he will sell. That is his business model, right? Why are you interested in my talk today? Because of Three Idiots, maybe because of Two States, something like that. But today I am not talking to you about all that. So what you saw, Three Idiots, Two States, that was the monkey dance. Today is the churan you are getting of life, you are learning, okay? So first step, entertain people, then they are listening to you. Once they are listening to you, you try to change them. Try to give them some knowledge about, make them better. So I told you I'm not the best in writing. In writing I'm not supposed to be, I'm not trained to be a writer. So how do I win? I won by changing the game. And that is why a lot of businesses win sometimes, even though they are small, they are not very big. They win against big competitors. How? By changing the game. Okay? In life, now they don't teach you this in school. In life, there are two kinds of people. You know, one is winners who do better than others. And the second is winners who change the game. Right? Now, if there is a tennis match and it's Nadal versus Federer, right? If Nadal has to win today, he has to play better tennis. He can only win by first method. Right? He cannot take a racket five times bigger and say, I want to change the game. He can't do that, right? But in business, in life, you can always change the game. Never think that the rules are set and therefore I cannot win against this. You can always change the game. So, why this happens? Why do winners who are not the best win? Comes from this quote, which is very important quote about life, about nature, given by Charles Darwin. Okay, who was Charles Darwin? He used to study nature. He used to study, biology. He's a biologist. And he said this about nature. It is not the most intelligent that survives. It is not the most strong that survives. It is the most adaptive that survives. You understand what I'm saying? We tell our children, you come first, come first, come first, be intelligent, intelligent people do well. Nature doesn't care. Now, can we fight against nature? No. We cannot fight against nature. What does well in life is not the strong person. What does well in life is not the intelligent person. What does well is the person who adapts with time. In Hindi we call it jo samay ke saath badle. You know, 30 years have passed. All the analogies in that video were about a marathon, about the long race. Ye lambi race hai, lekin lambi race mein ek tarike se nahi bhagna hai. Things will keep changing. How you sold real estate 30 years ago is different today. In 7 years it will be different. In fact, the world is changing faster than before. So this is how nature works. I'll give you an example so that you never forget this concept. Okay? Millions of years ago, the strongest creatures on earth were dinosaurs. Dinosaurs were very big. They were the rulers. They would be the 5 times bigger than elephants. They would walk around and they were ruling. Then the ice started melting and all the dinosaurs died. All of them. Now you can't see a dinosaur. Only in movies you see special effects. No more dinosaurs. Millions of years ago, there was another creature we don't respect called cockroach. You know, cockroaches were there millions of years ago. Cockroaches are there even now. Cockroaches, you'll find them everywhere, even today. They're living in the poshest colonies of Hyderabad. Banjara Hills, Jubilee, high-tech, they are living everywhere. I mean real cockroaches, not like writer I am trying to say anything else. Okay. Why? Because cockroach is the most adaptive creature on earth. We never respect, we don't even like them. But there is something to learn. Cockroach, what does adaptive mean? What does it mean in practical terms? It means being like, it's okay. we'll adjust. Now it can, this attitude needs to be there at work also. You know, if something is changing, you shouldn't be like, I'm not going to change. You have to be like, it's okay, I'll adjust. So cockroaches adjust. We used to live in, cockroaches are like, okay, first we used to live in jungle, now we have to live in Gachibowli. It's okay, we'll adjust. First we used to eat leaves and insects, now we have to eat Kellogg's. It's okay, we'll adjust. They change their diet. Other animals can't change their diet. Cockroaches can eat anything. They're fine, right? One of the ways you tell that a species is doing well is if they're reproducing. If they're reproducing, means life is good. Cockroaches reproduce anywhere. In the car, in the kitchen, at night, male cockroach will call the female cockroach. Are you come? She's like, what are you saying? This is hard Italian marble. He's like, it's okay. Dil mein jagah honi chahiye. You know, they should be placed in the heart. Then they're fine, right? They're like, what are you doing? How can we do now? Yesterday, Chacha Ji was killed in the spray. They're like, it's okay, we'll bring new Chacha Ji to the world. Cockroaches are the most adjusted creatures. Think about this. There are companies in this world, multinationals, like Baygon, HIT. What are their purpose? Like ARC has a mission above, and their mission is one, kill the cockroaches, right? They have millions of dollars of capital, they have HR, finance, they must be having conferences like this, they must be going to office. Children asking their fathers, dad, where are you going? I'm going to office. Why are you going? I'm going to kill cockroaches today. Have they been able to? With government sanction, with human beings not liking that creature, nobody likes cockroaches. And with big, big companies putting hundreds of crores behind in capital, they are not able to kill it. What a creature. Think about it. Right? You know why? They get used to the spray. It goes in the blood. It's like single malt for them. Chalo yaar, aaj spray laga ke aate. Now that is the attitude you need to have in life if you want to win. I am not the best writer, but I am the best cockroach. And that is what is leading to you calling me as chief guest and not even knowing who is the best writer right now. So remember that about life. Strongest don't survive, those who adapt to. People who are adapting. I'm going to give you examples of my own field and then we come to you guys back. But when I first wrote a book, only very hi-fi English books used to sell. You know Shashi Tharoor English. There is Chetan Bhagat English, there is Shashi Tharoor English in India. But English is not one in India. There's many, many English. The whole industry was trying to write books like that. Because publishing industry is full of dinosaurs. I'll tell you, how do you know that you are a dinosaur? The bigger your ego, the bigger the dinosaur you are. Some jobs, you are not allowed to have ego. Entrepreneur cannot have ego. You can't have ego in business because you have to, you are below the customer. Customer is here, you are here. Where are you having ego from? You can't have. But in literature, there is a lot of ego. Are we write hi-fi English? I wrote a book in very simple English at that time. Now, at that time, something else was happening in India. Something was changing. You don't adapt just like that. You adapt to change. You adapt to environment changing, right? What was changing? Millions of people in India were learning English, especially in the 2004, like when my book came out. They were always studying English in government schools, but now mobile phones were coming, computers were coming, laptops were coming. So you get to practice some English. You have to know send, you have to know receive, contacts, save, login, password. These are people who knew basic English now. How many books are being written for them in the publishing industry? Zero. Right? But the whole industry was sleeping, you know. So that's when I wrote this book, 5.someone at that time, sold 13 lakh copies at that time. Now that changed the industry. After that they said, we want this same market, which is Indian people reading Indian English books. And now if you go to bookstop, everybody is writing those books. I also wrote more, you may have heard. Then I did something else, which was another cockroach-like adaptation, to go to Bollywood. Bollywood is not a joke. And this was an even harder adaptation, which I am telling you, you may have to face. By now, I was already a star in my field. I'm already Chetan Bhagat, who's selling the most books. Bollywood, nobody knew me. They don't read books there in English. Now they may be, but in that time, 15 years ago, they were not reading. They don't know IIT, all this. They're like, ah, okay, fine. So if I want a meeting in Bollywood, and they say, you have to wait 3 hours outside my office, I have to wait. Now you're already a star in your field. So it's very difficult. Because you want to be treated like, okay, you know. But it doesn't happen like that. In Bollywood, if they say, I'll meet you at 10 o'clock tomorrow, it means maybe day after. That's how they work. I have come from a different culture, in a bank and all that. But I said, what would a cockroach do? First books, okay, movies have this culture, we'll go like this. They want me to wait, I'll wait. What is the big deal? If I wait, maybe I'll have a movie. If I don't wait, if I want to be a star, I go back to books, I will remain in books. That is what you need to understand. You may be doing something at Arc Group, which you are very good at. You are selling certain kind of property, real estate. Now you go to different area, you are not getting the same respect. You are not getting the same success. You are not getting the same response. Now you may want to run back to your comfort zone. Don't do that. You're not going to grow. You have to say, it's okay. What would the cockroach do? I will just go and do it. It's okay. I'll adjust. You know, I did this. Lot of these movies came. I have also written a Telugu movie in Hindi. Huh? This movie called Kick. Anybody seen Kick? Yeah, everybody's seen. It's a big hit movie. After I did this, I told you in the beginning, my goal was change. Therefore, it was time for one more adaptation. After now, I was known as a writer who writes love stories, who writes Bollywood, who writes these things. But I said, I want to write on national issues now. So I started writing on national issues. Maybe many of you have seen my columns. But it's an adaptation. If you are writing Salman Khan movies, who will take you seriously on the budget? But I said, you know what, I'm going to try and do it. I also did something different which people in India don't do, especially English writers. English writers in India never write in Hindi. I said, I'm going to start writing in Hindi. Because you can't reach the country if you are not writing in the local language. But in India, English writers, you'll never find them even talking in Hindi. They are born in English. In hospital, when they are born, they cry in English. So, this is, but if you want to reach your country, you have to. Once you do all this, you get invited to horror shows. Have you seen? Don't Watch Alone. It's a very big adaptation for me. Because two adaptations. One is, till now my name was getting famous, not the face. Books, films, columns, name. Face here. Second very big adaptation, when I write a book, when I write a column, I can fix it for 1 week. I can edit, I can polish it. It's live here. He gives you 3 seconds. Actually, he doesn't even give you 3 seconds. I figured out how to get the 3 seconds. The way to get it is, I realized he keeps talking, but he will have to breathe. At some point he has to stop and breathe, you know. So then I said, okay, I will do it like this. I also did this. Anybody remember this? I did a dance show. Even by my cockroach standards, this was too much. Because I don't think there is any author in the world who has judged a dance show. But I did it for strategic reason. This is one of the biggest shows in the country. Even Panwala watches it. Panwala watches this show, then sees the Hindi newspaper in his shop. He sees my article and he says, "Arey, this is the Nach Baliya guy. Let me read it." Authors don't want to be on it because they write books and they're like, how can we write one line? But sometimes one line can have a bigger effect than you know, anything else. Today you have heard of me more because I have gone, which your motto is, above and beyond books. I am known as a book author, but I am doing books, films, print media, stage, social networks, television. Books is 20% of my revenue today. 80% is not books. So when you think that we are big enough, if you think differently, you can grow, keep on growing. As long as you keep adapting, keep on trying different things, don't have that dinosaur-like ego, you'll be fine. I want to come to the last part of this, which is about you guys. It's very good to come to a big show like this, big conference, get motivated, see laser shows, audio videos, motivational speaker, go above and beyond. But you know what? Unless you feel from within that you want to go above and beyond, you will not go above and beyond. Unless you feel that I need to keep doing things in life, no matter what your chairman or CEO keeps saying, it's okay. It's their job to say, it's our job to do our work and go home. It will not happen. When will it happen? When it is coming from within you. So it's important to answer this question. You know, why do it? Why ARC has to grow now? It's enough, no? So big. Why you need to become 5 times bigger? They said, why? Why challenge yourself? Why not just chill? Same question I also face. My mother told me, why you are doing all these things? Politics, books, film, why you do? Relax, do less, you are 45 years old now. Why don't you chill? You have made some money. Punjabi mothers have a way of saying things which hits the point. She said, whatever money you are making now, your daughter-in-law is going to spend it. You are not going to keep it. You can't spend it. It's your daughter-in-law that is going to buy diamond earrings with your money. So you are working hard at this age, but the money is going to be... Now I said, yeah, maybe yeah, she's right. I don't know. You know, why challenge? Why go above and beyond? Why not go home and sleep? Low can be that. So I'll tell you why. Why it's important to challenge yourself. And that is why I asked you in the beginning, how old are you guys? 30s, 40s, 50s. A lot of you here have reached the stage that you have worked for a few years and you become, life has become stable, you know. But you'll also find what I find. I meet people like you every day. I find people are in 3 different categories. There are people who exist, there are people who are fading, and there are people who are alive. Let me explain what does this mean. Exist are most people. They are people who are neither happy nor are they sad. You know, you ask people, most people, how are you doing? Yeah, it's okay. Yaar. How is life? Life is cut rahi hai. Cut rahi hai. My friends say this. Cut rahi hai. What are you asking? What are you happy? I'm not unhappy. Are you happy? I'm not that happy. It's okay. Life is normal. You know, I call these people, people who are waiting for their funeral. Kab aayega funeral? It's like these people in their 30s, 40s, are yaar Chetan, stop it now, this motivation. We are in our 30s now. Now it's the kids' time. अभी बच्चों का टाइम है. हमने तो कर लिया, हमने अपना टाइम कर लिया. अब हमारी एज है, 30s हो गई है, यू नो, अब हमें वो एनर्जी नहीं है. वी डोंट हैव द एनर्जी नाउ. वी आर 30 ईयर ओल्ड, आई एम 40 नाउ. आई डोंट हैव दैट सेम एनर्जी. व्हाट इज द एवरेज एज ऑफ पॉलिटिशियंस इन इंडिया? 125. You saw in Maharashtra, Sharad Pawar, how he was fighting for his for the state after the election. I don't know if you are following. I'm not going to comment on politics, but I'm saying look at that age. He's close to 80 years old, and he was there fighting. He was giving a rally in the rain. You saw the photo. So what you are saying at 30s, 40s, you don't have the energy. If I tell you that Deepika Padukone has also come outside, you will all run out. I know my importance. How does the energy come from? It is not energy. It is motivation. Don't confuse energy with motivation. If you have motivation for something, you get the energy. Energy at any age. And if you are feeling, "Arey, it's okay, now I'm 30s, 40s, Abhi, it's okay, now kids will do." That's not right. You know what has happened to you? You have become what the Indian middle class dream is. If you notice any matrimonial ad, they want a settled boy. Not just settled, well settled. You know where the word settled comes from? It comes from, in school you did sedimentation experiment. You mix mud and water and you leave it. Then over time the mud will settle down, and in the diagram you call it settle. That is settle. Opposite of entrepreneur, opposite of risk taking. How many of you here can paint? Paint? Okay, so 1,000 people, 2-5 people. I asked the same question when I have twin boys. When they were 4 years old, I went to their class. I asked this question, sir. How many of you can paint? What do you think happened, sir? Everybody raised their hand. Everybody. But here? No. When you were 4 years old, you would have raised your hand. Now? Settle. Now you're settled. Why to raise? Children are born risk takers. Children are born entrepreneurs. Human beings are born entrepreneurs. Human beings can stay entrepreneurs at 30, at 40, 60, 70, 80, 90 also. Do you know Clint Eastwood? You heard of Clint Eastwood? He's a big filmmaker. He's making movies now. In his youth, he was like Rajnikanth-like star, fighting, masala movies. Now he is making Oscar winning movies. You know his age now? 90. He is making movies at 90. So don't tell me that at 30, 40 it's that. 30, 40 is middle, almost you are getting to the interval of your life. Now in Hindi movies, a good movie is where second half is better than first half. So if your life is a movie, make it a good movie, na? Don't say अभी हम best part is over, अभी तो बस ending की wait हो रही है, समोसा लेकर आओ. ऐसा मत करो, you know. So don't be settled, don't. Because if you stay like this, you will become fading. People who don't challenge themselves, don't do anything, they just become more like fading. Fading are who people, negative people. We all have one relative who comes home and it feels like somebody has died. They always have negative look at life. Nothing is good. I call them DA, Dukhi Atma. You know, this happens to people if you stay, exist for life. And then you have people who are alive. These are people who look forward to life, who feel the spark, who have ambition. 70-year-old, 80-year-old people who have looking forward to something. Wedding in the family, holiday, something. Fitness, finishing steps on your watch, you know, your next promotion, your career, something. These are the people who are alive, right? Why does this happen? Why do people do this? Why are some people exist? Why are some people fading? Why are some people alive? Here's my theory. Whenever you have a new challenge in life, you will feel very excited. Then you become little okay. First day you got job with ARC, you were super excited. Wow, I got a job with ARC. Now if someone asks you, how is your job with ARC? Are same job, yaar, what do you keep asking? You don't feel so excited. It's okay now. And then over time it is going down. So how do you always stay excited? How do you always stay alive? I stay alive by being like this. By adding new challenges. Because when you do this, you stay in the alive zone. That is why it's important to grow. Why do you think Mukesh Ambani is still working? If he's careful, I'm sure he guzara to chala sakte hai apna. Zara shaadi ke card thode kam bana le. He can do. Why is Amitabh Bachchan still working? He is working 15 hours a day. Why? He can't spend. All these people are working. Why does Salman Khan still work? Means he goes to the gym 3 hours a day. Why? For this. They want to feel alive. It's not about the money. It's not about anything else. If you don't challenge yourself, if you don't push yourself, you will become unhappy in life. Therefore, if you are in an organization that wants to grow, that wants to grow double, 4 times, 10 times, it's good. You don't want to be in a place where there is no interest in any change, where everybody says, abhi bas settle ho jao. It is not about being settled in life. Doing nothing in life is very boring. You know they say, uski wahan shaadi hui hai, usko wahan ungli bhi nahi uthani padti. This was before the touch screen was invented. Now ungli to uthani padegi. But it's a horrible life when you do nothing with your life. So if you want to avoid this feeling of exist in 30s and 40s, if you don't want to just live your second half waiting for the funeral, then you must keep on adding more challenges. I would love to say I'm doing all this writing for like national service, but I'm not. I'm doing for myself. Because I keep doing these different things, it makes me feel alive. At 45, I have more drive today. I have so many things to look forward to in the next 10 years than I did in 20 or 25. Don't be that person who says, now there is nothing much left in life. I've done everything. Till your last day, you can keep trying to do different things. Because that's what life is all about. That's what being alive is all about. Thank you so much for having me. Our group, wish you all the best. And I know I am not a real estate expert, but I'll say one real estate thing. I used to work in a bank, and I used to work in Hong Kong, and I used to work with real estate companies. And I met once Lee Ka Shing, who's the richest guy in Hong Kong. He owns almost a lot of the real estate in Hong Kong. And there was a downturn. And he said, we asked him, are you worried about the downturn? He said, this downturn is there, but real estate will always be there. Because in Asian culture, a mother-in-law will never respect a man till he buys his house. So I'm not worried. Mother-in-laws will save my business always. Because ultimate dream of everyone is to buy a house. Up, down will keep coming and going. Ultimately, people want to buy a house. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it nice and loud for Mr. Chetan Bhagat. Sir, if you don't mind, Chetanji, if you don't mind, can we take a selfie with this awesome audience?
Yeah, yeah, sure. I already took, but we'll take another one.
Are you in or are you in? Come on, make some noise.
Okay.
Oh, all right.
Come.
I'm going to include myself as well as part of the audience.
Okay. Okay.
So can we do this with mine as well?
I'll post.
Everybody, make some noise, come on. Hold up your hands as well so we can see that you're part of the photograph.